Crusader Nation. I'm Caitlin Bross.
And I'm Katie Poley.
Here with all you need to know about Empower Hour.
It's a new school year, and the new thing for all of us is this fancy new lunch hour.
Let's start out with the basics. Empower Hour is between second and third period. Whether you're behind in a class, need to make a meeting, or grab a bite to eat, Empower Hour is to empower you.
Every meeting you have will only be 30 minutes, so you have the other half to eat and chat with friends. If you ever lose track of what is going on, the TV outside the Learning Commons will have every meeting posted every day. Not to mention, you can use your phone during Empower Hour. While you eat, you can scroll through Twitter or send a text, but just remember that you cannot make calls. And most importantly, remember that Empower Hour is a privilege and consequence will occur if you're not following the guidelines. But enough of the overview, let's really get down to what this hour is all about.
All right, Katie, let's go to the cafeteria and talk about the most important part of Empower Hour, lunch. Now that we are here, we have some exciting news. You don't actually have to eat lunch in the cafeteria, weird, right? Of course, all school food will be bought in here, but you can eat it in many other places, including the Kathy Fetter Commons, Sister Mary Bender Lobby, Senior Picnic Tables, and the Oak Grove.
Also, with the teacher or campus minister's permission, you may eat in their classroom or the hub. Make sure to throw away all trash in designated trash cans, not in the teacher's classroom. All lunch trays have to go back to the cafeteria, and students who are eating in different locations throughout the school will be asked to wipe down their table. Say adios to the typical cafeteria lunch and hello to freedom.
Since lunch is only one half of Empower Hour, what do we do with the rest? Let's go to the hub and find out.
For you seniors and freshmen, advisory meets the first half of Empower Hour, Mondays and Tuesdays every week. Peer ministers will do the same to plan for upcoming masses and retreats. These scheduled events will be first priority during Empower Hour.
For sophomores, juniors, and seniors, you will be assigned a check-in teacher at the beginning of the year. Every Tuesday, you will meet to receive updates, do grade checks, and sometimes have class meetings for the first or last 15 minutes. Freshmen and seniors will meet at the beginning of the hour, while sophomores and juniors will meet at the end. The other days, you decide how you will use Empower Hour.
You'll have the opportunity to make a meeting or two. These will be held on Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday. College presentations will also be held during this time. Clubs and other meetings will be posted and can be held pretty much anywhere in the school. Just keep your ears open on where your club will meet.
But the best part about Empower Hour is time to talk to teachers. Let's go find someone and ask them about their office hours. Hey, Mr. Asher.
Hey, ladies.
Can you tell us a little more about your office hours this year?
Sure. It's a time I will set out weekly for students to come talk to me about their classes. I may also have review or study sessions. It's really a time for you. I really encourage all students to use these office hours. It's really the best way they can empower themselves, no pun intended.
Thanks so much. I'm sure I'll be using these all year.
Great.
Don't forget, if you ever miss school, remember it is your responsibility to talk to your teachers during their office hours to get your makeup work. Now let's go check out some other cool things you can do during Empower Hour.
When you aren't hitting the books, you can be hitting the grind in the fitness center. It'll be open every day besides Friday. Another way to stay active is intramurals, which will take place on Fridays throughout the school year.
Let's go to the Learning Commons to finish up everything you need to know about Empower Hour.
This is awesome, but remember, you can't eat lunch in here. It is for studying, group collaboration, and taking quizzes. Also, make sure to use Empower Hour efficiently. If misused, you may get a detention or loss of privileges.
If you're struggling in a class, there will also be what we call academic overtime for students. Basically, if you have a 69% or below in a class, you'll have to spend half of Empower Hour studying for what you are struggling with. This is some encouragement to keep your grades up at the beginning of school.
Overall, this is something St. Dominic is really excited about. It will be a big transition, but an exhilarating one. Make sure to use Empower Hour the right way, and this can be your best year yet. Finally, this is Caitlin Bross
and Katie Poley
signing off.